Hi, my name is Elliott Grant, and I'm a data scientist. And I also love Mongolian growth. So I was really, really impressed to find out 6 months ago that my favorite spot had closed. But I also saw an opportunity. I thought that if I could predict the probability that a restaurant was likely to close, that could be really useful information for stakeholders, investors, anyone interested in that. My starting point for this project was a Yelp academic data set from January that had information on 35,000 US restaurants. And then I was able to ping the Google Maps API to find out which of those restaurants had closed. About 2% of those restaurants had closed, or about 700 restaurants in that 500. Here's the distribution. As you can see, it's mostly isolated to certain locations. This is all of the restaurants, not just the ones that are closed. So you can see, like, even though it's isolated to certain locations, but later on the model will be able to make predictions for any restaurant in any location. For my data sources, my primary source was the Yelp academic data set, which provided some basic information such as categories, American, Chinese food attributes, do they serve alcohol, is there bike parking, Wi-Fi, how many reviews are there, how many stars does it have, what's the price point. I also used the United States Census Bureau. This data was really poorly documented and hard to access. I actually scraped the website for all the zip codes and in my database. And this is an example of some information: income, age, poverty, number of veterans for that zip code. I also used Yelp review text because I thought that I would get different signals from the data depending on how many stars were associated with each review text. I bucketed the reviews into 1-star, 2-, 4-star, and 5-star reviews. So if someone says the word service in a 1-star review, that would provide a lot different signal than if they said 5-star, or they said service in a 5-star. Also, because I had 322 review features, which was a lot, but I only had 700 closed restaurants in the data set, I plugged all those into a gradient boosted model just using those values to predict the restaurant were close. And then I kept only the top 100 features, text-based features, in my model throughout the others. I also used Google Maps to get information on how the restaurant compares to nearby restaurants. I thought it could be an important signal if a restaurant is higher or lower price, or how does it compare in consumer ratings. Also, what about restaurant density in that area? For modeling, I used 4 different types of classification models. And gradient boosting was the best performer and had a AUC of 0.726. As you can see, I had by far the most features that came from reviews and from Yelp. So when you look at this feature important by data source, it makes sense that reviews would be one of the top ones because there were so many features to use. But Google Maps came in at number 2. Even though there were only 6 features from Google Maps. So I think that was really important information for the volunteers. Potential improvements, more features. I think that's the biggest weakness of this project at this point is just predictive power. So increasing that would be really important. Also getting a probability on any restaurant where a user could go and plug in a restaurant and then get the probability that it's going to be close. Also more business categories, such as services and retail. And here's a demo of the website. As you can see, these are all currently open restaurants, and on the right you see this is the representation of the probability of close. Those in red are high likelihood of closing, and those in green are safe. Let's zoom in on Galvanize and see what's nearby. So if you're considering somewhere for lunch, consider supporting a restaurant that might not be there next week. And you see that Mediterranean mix has a closing probability of 25%. Keep watching.
Thank you.
I didn't really greatly look into that because there's a lot of features. It's kind of hard to do that type of analysis, especially since there's a lot of complex interactions going on with the ensemble model, like gradient boosting. I didn't want to over talk too much about causation.
Well, I definitely think if I was a restaurant owner and I came up with a probability of close, I'd want to know, oh, what do I need to do? What's going wrong, right? But let's say, you know, I was a restaurant owner and I was just sort of concerned about this, right? Because I had a few restaurants that closed in the past. What other data would you go get you think would help me understand if my restaurant was going to close soon?
That's a really good question. I would focus on where they were the most feature, where the feature performance were the best. So I think Google Maps data, how does that restaurant compare to restaurants nearby? It's going to be really important to understand all those features. And then review text, getting more insights about the customers and their experience there.
Cool, thank you. Brian Boone, up next.